Hello, welcome. Hello, everybody. Beautiful day, isn't it? It's a bit warm in the unit, but hey, we're gonna cook some fantastic fish for you tonight. We're gonna do some tuna. Caroline is behind the camera and she'll be joining us shortly. I just want to say to everybody, thank you for supporting us in West Dean. It was a wonderful weekend. There comes Caroline.
Hello, everybody. Just getting the camera working. It's lovely to be here again this evening.
Yeah.
Yeah, we had a wonderful time at West
Dean. Yes.
Fabulous show as always.
Yeah, beautiful.
The weather was good and we just got together with all our friends, didn't we?
Yeah.
It's just such a good, party atmosphere. If you haven't been to West Dean Chili Festival in Chichester, then you need to try and go next year.
Yeah, it's the one to go. It's lots of activities for kids.
We have some great shows, but it's just a beautiful place and it's parkland. It's lovely.
It is.
And what are we cooking this week then?
Well, tonight we're going to use our jerk paste.
Yeah.
We're going to use a jerk paste and we're going to make a, how you say it, Caroline?
I have no idea what
we're
going to
do
about.
Some aubergine.
Yes, I'm doing the aubergine.
Yeah.
You're doing the fish, aren't you?
With fish, tuna fish, kebabs with
spaghetti.
With some spaghetti, and we're going to make a cream.
Parmesan.
Cream parmesan sauce.
I don't know what's going on.
Saucy thing.
He can't remember.
It's much easier when you're at home and you're doing it than when you're in the camera telling people what you're doing, you know?
So, one of the things is that we've got the tuna fish. On Facebook, it says monkfish. Went to Waitrose, lovely Waitrose, little plug there, and they just sold the last piece.
The last piece.
So, as our normal improvisation, we said we'll do tuna, which is just as good.
Yeah, because tuna is it's meaty as well, but it's it doesn't flick away like the cod and the haddock, as you know. So
we're going to do kebabs,
yeah.
Aren't we?
So we're going to do kebabs with it.
So it has to be firm.
Yes.
So I think I'm in the wrong place.
Are you?
We need to swap over.
So okay.
You mentioned about the jerk paste. For those of you who don't know, this is part of our tropical range, isn't
it? That's right.
No added sugar. We were selling loads of it at West Dean.
Yeah, ideal for barbecues. Could marinate the chicken and have a barbecue. And it has no sugar. I use sun-dried tomatoes, so it wouldn't burn on the barbecue.
Yeah, so you get the sweetness, don't you?
You get the sweetness from the sun-dried tomatoes. That's right, yeah.
However, if you don't have this and you don't have time to go and purchase it, then use whatever mix that you've got at home that's similar.
Yes.
So there's that. So you're going to get on and do spaghetti in a minute.
Do the spaghetti.
So
put it on.
One thing, we've got fresh spaghetti. So this is fresh. It actually only takes 4 minutes to
I'm gonna cheat a bit.
To cook.
I'm gonna put some hot water already boiled from the kettle.
Yeah, it's good.
Speeds up the process.
We've got 250 grams of spaghetti. We've got about 30 grams here of Parmesan. You can use a bit more if you like. And we've got 240 ml of single cream. So those together with some chopped chives are going to make a lovely spaghetti, creamy, chivey mix, aren't they?
Yeah.
And I'll swap over
with
you.
We soaked the aubergine in some salted water.
So I'll get those out.
Which we're going to drain and we're going to put it on the George Foreman and grill it. On the George Foreman, and it's going to go in the base of the plate, and then we're going to top it up with the spaghetti, with the parmesan and the cream and the chives.
It's going to be delicious.
And then we're going to put the kebabs on top. We're going to make a nice kind of what do you call it? A freestyle.
Freestyle.
Yeah.
And we're going to, on the kebabs, we're going to use a red pepper. So you need one red pepper.
Yeah.
One aubergine. You probably won't. And well, we love aubergine, so you might not want to use a whole aubergine.
We could just use.
I think I'll eat the other bit because you know how I love my veggies.
Okay.
And then we've got 240 grams of tuna fish, and that's been marinating. How long have you marinated? About 3 hours.
Yeah, about 3 hours.
In the jerk marinade.
Because the fish is delicate, it doesn't need as long as the meat. So.
So
it has all these juices, so it will go through the fish much quicker.
So, we're going to turn the George Foreman on to get hot. Now, we're going to prepare these, aren't we, by...
Put some oil on the...
Yeah, on the aubergine and the peppers.
We'll be doing them all together.
Yeah, I'm going to do them all together. So, you do your bit, and I'll do my bit.
Okay.
So, all I'm going to do is lightly brush the peppers.
She's the boss.
They don't know that. You just told them. They would never have guessed had you not told them. Why
the
did
women,
you tell them?
The women is always the boss.
Why did you go and let that secret out?
That's all right, mate. I don't mind.
So I'm going to just paint these with a little oil.
Right. So I'm going to cut the fish into cubes. Again, it's a very easy dish.
That one's done.
Not too difficult. You can see the tuna is nice and thick.
And what I'll do in a minute, I'll pop around and make sure that the video's still live and still working, because they've changed the interface, so it's a little bit different. Right, so when that light...
It's ready.
Is it ready?
Yeah.
Right. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to pop these on the grill to start them off. I'm just going to put the four on for now, and the pepper.
So we'll make that mix.
Put that lid down. It's not quite sizzling yet, but...
Is it?
Mm-hmm. Yes, it's started to sizzle. So I'm going to come round and just check that the video's working. Hello. Hi, Lisa.
Hello.
I'll come around the back to make sure it's working. Brilliant. So we'll give you a close... Oh, he's messing my dinner up. Close up of the tuna. Hi, Ryan.
Hello, guys.
Here's a close up.
Oh, sorry.
Those slippery little buggers, eh? Right, okay. So I'm going to put you back down and go back round the front. Hope you can all see okay.
Yeah. So, Caroline Desres.
Right, I'm coming back.
What I reckon we should do two kebabs with the fish.
So I've got a message from Ryan here. I'm just going to interrupt you. He says, good to see you guys on Sunday. Can't wait to try out my tropical garlic sauce. If it's anything like the coconut one, it will be amazing.
Nice one, Ryan. I'm going to make a chef out of you, mate. So what I reckon we should do, Caroline, is...
Maybe he makes chefs out of us.
Yeah.
But I'm going to leave those two off because they won't fit
just in. Just the two. And then we will chop the vegetables and make it look.
So are you going to put some red pepper on those as well? I thought that was the plan.
I know, but I think if we chop it and we make it look nice...
All right then.
You know?
He's changed it. He always changed it.
Okay, I'll tell you what. We'll do one like this. And one red pepper.
Stick it.
Pepper is not ready yet.
Oh no, go on.
That's why I thought if we do that.
That's okay.
I know, I always change things like.
It's all right, I just have to catch up with him. He doesn't mind that we're actually filming this, do you? You just go, she'll catch up eventually. Right, water's boiling. Shall I put the spaghetti in?
Yes.
So we're just going to put it into a good amount of salt.
Now that's a proper kebab.
Of boiling water.
Look at them there. Again, the dish is going to be a quick one. It's not going to take too long.
Turn it up, bring it to the boil again. And then just cook it until...
That is ready.
They said 4 minutes, but sometimes I do it slightly less. He's still throwing the peppers out.
You need to turn them.
Yeah. So, turn them over. That's right, so those will turn over.
Oh! Cut them too big, love.
You're out of control.
Cut them too big. Whoa! She cut them too big.
Blame me.
Oh, you put it too high. You're fired.
I'm fired.
Yes, you're fired.
Spa, here I come.
I'll do a Gordon Ramsay in you.
I know there's a spa waiting for me to arrive where I won't have to do any cooking or anything.
You're rushing the food, man.
Right, okay, so don't turn it up too high and boil it over like I did.
Right, so we have the fish kebabs ready. And once the vegetables are ready, we're going to put the fish kebab and then we're going to make
the sauce.
The sauce.
So, that's easy.
So I'll leave you in charge of that, shall I?
Okay, so I'm going to chop up some chives.
You want the big knife, eh?
I'll get it for you.
I'll get it for you, don't worry.
Any herb that you like will do. Anything that you fancy. You could put
You want to put this more? Oh, come on. So aggressive.
Mind your fingers.
So aggressive, you know?
I know.
You want to cuddle? This will happen when you cook together.
What, you
too many cooks in the house.
So, chop up your herbs.
That's right.
Whatever they are. Dill would go quite nicely.
That's enough. Can I show you, baby? That's enough.
Fingers in the way, I'll tell you.
Oh wow, nice.
Tell them a nice story about the Caribbean.
It's very hot.
It is, it's very hot, very pleasant.
Oh god, I don't know what to say, guys. You know, I really don't know what to say. It's coming. Yeah, so those of you guys who I keep telling about your fish. Again, you could take the fish, like the tuna we had, put it on a piece of foil, take the jerk paste, one little wee spoon, dessert spoon or tablespoon, spread it all over the fish, make a little pocket in a hot oven or under a grill. And you could do the same for any of the tropical sauces. And it's a quick, easy dish you could have. You come from work, you don't want to spend too much time, you just want, 15 minutes. Fish takes 5 minutes to cook. So it's an easy dish to do. So we're trying this one today. I mean, aubergine. I think it was my fourth or fifth time I've had aubergine.
Yeah, because you don't get them in that.
No, you don't get them in Caribbean. Well, oh no. We get them. We get them. We call them eggplants. Is it the same thing?
Yes.
That's right. Yeah. We get them in the Caribbean. Eggplants.
So I'll just put a little extra oil on there just to get them to. Cook a bit quicker.
Yeah.
And it'll take a little while, don't they?
Yeah. This weekend we're doing two shows. Caroline is doing Winchester. There is a cheese and chili show in Winchester, and I'm doing Worthing.
So Winchester's a 2-day show.
And Worthing is a 1-day show. So the Saturday is Worthing and Saturday and Sunday is Winchester. So if you guys are around, pop down, you know?
Yeah, it'd be good to see you.
Yeah, it'd be good to see you guys.
So while that's cooking, I just wanted to introduce you to a product I found. Hang on. It's a lovely, lovely, lovely product. I found this at West Dean, and I bought some last year, and I went back to get some more. And it's made from, it's a vinegar, but...
That says ready. Did you time it?
Yes, that's ready. You can drain it. Hopeless, aren't we? So... They're infused. So this one's infused with rose petal, and this one's an elderflower vinegar, and it's made by Strata. So that's www.strata.org. They're in Sussex, and the ingredients on here, this one is white wine vinegar, natural sugar, Gertrude Jekyll roses, and the people actually grow them. This one has won a 3-star Great Taste Award. It's an elderflower. Again, white wine vinegar, natural sugar, Sussex elderflowers. And it's got a gold award. And they are absolutely delicious. I use them as a salad dressing. So I just thought I'd introduce you because they're so good. I thought you might like to investigate for yourselves.
Nice.
And they come in a little bag like that. It's pretty, isn't it?
Yeah, nice little bag. So right, so So the pasta is cooked. So we're going to put the...
So what we're going to do...
Put the cream and the parmesan.
We'll do that in a minute though, because we want to cook the fish first. So I'm going to take out... Ready yet, but you can go back in with the fish.
Okay, and I put a little bit of oil on the fish.
I think this one, if I move them to there,
I just brush a little oil on there so it doesn't stick.
Can your fish still fit in there?
I'll try, yeah.
So I'm actually going to just leave the aubergines in slightly longer.
So just put a little bit of oil on it.
Take these out of the way. Now we cut like our red peppers or peppers quite crispy, so these are still like the al dente. So what I'm going to do is just to slice these.
So the fish is on now.
And they've just had a little sort of char grill, if you like. You can see there, they're just charred slightly. I'm going to just drop a tiny little bit of the odd flake of sea salt on there, just so that can melt in while everything else is cooking.
So this parmesan is for the spaghetti, and I'm putting some more so I can spread it
on the top
when it's finished.
So next, just take your chopped herbs. I'm going to pop them in the cream like this. And then I will just mix that in.
Looks nice.
Yeah, it's going to be delish.
So it's not a massive meal. It's one of those meals that you feel just right. You're not over full, but you feel that you had something.
Yeah, it's nice and healthy.
Yeah.
Well. Maybe and, apart from the single cream.
Yeah.
But I bought organic single cream.
Yeah. And with the jerk paste on the fish, the jerk paste is hot, but the spaghetti with the cream will balance, so you wouldn't get it too hot. It will act
it's
like
lovely,
a
isn't it?
Yeah.
Because you get the two different. You get the heat of the fish.
Fish.
And then the spaghetti is you've got like slightly salty flavour.
Salty.
From,
yeah.
You know, from the parmesan and slightly creamy. And then we've got the vegetables to make it healthy. So you've got two of your five a day.
Yeah.
And you've got two colours, purple and red.
That's right.
So you just need your yellow, your orange, your green, your light green and dark green, and white.
That's a lot of colours.
Yeah, well, you should be eating like all your seven colours every day. So some of the work that I've done with people with learning difficulties, we always talk about eating colour, not what vegetables that you've eaten, but how many colours have you eaten each day. And we work with trying to say, you know, those seven colours, and what colours have you eaten, and try and fill in the gaps. So it's quite interesting, actually, because when you start thinking about what colours you're putting in your diet from vegetables, you know, it's kind of gets you looking in the supermarket, doesn't it? And actually changes your perception of what you're eating, I think, and helps. Because a lot of people who've worked with me who haven't got learning difficulties have also said that it's affected the way that they actually shop, because they think in terms of getting all their colours in every day. So it might be something you might want to think about too.
And it looks brilliant. The colours make it look vibrant. And
they do.
Right, so we can start doing the...
So I'm going to do, I'm going to do the cream sauce. So I'm just going to literally throw the cream on and add in the parmesan.
Yeah, because you don't want the cream to boil. You want it to just get... hot. You don't want it to start boiling. Once it starts boiling, I'll take it off here.
So I've just popped the cream. I'll come and show you. Just pop the cream and the parmesan and the herbs, and I'm just going to mix that and heat it through till the parmesan just melts. How's the fish doing?
Fish is doing fine.
Okay. Heat it there. And if you put tuna, you don't have to overcook it here. You can have it slightly pink in the middle.
Yeah. So the fish is almost ready.
I don't know if it's too much time, but I don't know.
Well, I think... How dare you?
Looks like a lot of green, green, green.
Well, what's in green?
Yeah.
He's laughing, only because he says there's too many chives, but I think it's perfect.
It's a lot of chives in there. Nice contrast, though. Nice contrast. Looks very, colourful.
Any of the soap water,
no.
Okay, I'm just going to add a fraction of water in there.
Nice.
But what you should actually do is better to do is to keep some of the water that it's cooked in, just in case it goes slightly dry, which is what happened here. So I'm just going to mix that until the parmesan is melted now.
Nice.
And it's hot all the way through.
Right, the fish is ready.
Not quite ready.
The aubergine is ready. We'll get a camera and show the guys what it looks like.
Right, I just need a little bit of salt and pepper now, so... If you leave it like this, I'll spoil it. Can you mix that with the camera?
Yeah.
Don't let it stick together.
Yeah.
Right, okay, we're going to give you a close up. Oh yeah, we're going to do some close-ups here. So, there's the fish and the spaghetti. Yeah, it's all turning over. The thing is, you can always...
This is the spaghetti.
Yeah, not too many chives. There are the guys. Hey, come on. Give me a vote here. Anybody watching, give me a vote. Are there too many chives? Put a thumbs up if you don't think there's too many. Oh. Okay.
No thumbs.
No thumbs, no. Being a bit thick, who's that? That's Caroline talking, and there's Chef Bernie. So,
right.
There we go.
That's ready.
Right, I'm putting you back down again. Why are you being thick, Richard? Hi, Barbara.
Hello, Barbara.
There you go, you can never have enough chives. You see, I knew I was okay.
I haven't heard from you for a while. We thought you went on holiday.
Right.
Right, fish is cooked.
Get me the aubergines. So, first thing is, we're going to put the aubergine. Little bit of pepper.
What do you want it?
So we're going to put the aubergine in the middle. That's enough on there. Okay, you can just put it around the side. Then we're going to pop the spaghetti. There, aren't they?
In the middle?
Yeah, just on the middle there. Brilliant. Okay. So lovely, creamy. That's perfect, look at that. Right, then we're going to put the fish on top. Wow. Yeah, superb. And that one, and I'll photograph that one. So we're going to photograph this one.
So there you go, guys. It took us 24 minutes to do this one.
I'll get the close up. So remember, salt and pepper to...
And then we're going
to
garnish it
to taste.
With the parmesan. Put some more parmesan.
Oh, Barbara's planning her next trip to St. Lucia.
Oh, she's in the UK.
You're in the UK, Barbara, at the moment? Well, I presume so.
Yes.
Okay.
Come down and cook with us.
Absolutely.
Yeah. So there you go, guys. So there you go.
Supper.
Supper is done.
So we need to test how hot this is. Now we're going to put that one to one side because I'm going to do some photographs. And I'm going to do the recipe for it.
So it took 24 minutes to cook that.
We've got a lovely meal. So there's a couple of things I wanted to mention. Our next live cooking in the first Tuesday of October, tickets are now live and we'll be sending out to you. So you can purchase and come and we will feed you all evening.
Yeah.
So lovely. I can't remember what you're going to do now, but it's basically all warm autumn-y lovely things.
And I know we have curry goat on the menu.
We do, don't we? And a pumpkin one pot.
Yeah.
Callaloo, is it you're doing or something? He might be persuaded. Anyway, the main thing is all the you can get a ticket.
And we're doing what you call a fish tea. It's a Caribbean thing. So, we're gonna try it now.
Bon appetit.
Very nice.
So, fish off, nice marinated fish. Looks good. Oh, that's nice.
Yeah, beautiful. The heat comes through, but it's not overpowering. And the fish,
it's
very
quite
tender.
Hot, isn't it? Yeah. I also get the slight citrusy flavours in there as well, which
and
is
that's
nice.
Why you have the spaghetti with the cream to cool your mouth down.
Well, some people might not want that, but Bernie's always mindful that I don't eat too hot a food. So I'm going to try the
It's just a precaution, you know, so. Your vision.
Lovely.
Yeah. When we soaked it in the salt went through it, so it doesn't taste bland. It has that the little flavor in it.
One more taste and then we'll say goodnight. Whoops.
And the peppers. Not too cooked. Real crunchy. All in all, a very good meal. A well-balanced meal.
Yum.
So there you go, guys.
I hope you all enjoyed that and that you'll do some cooking with us. And try out the recipes.
And if you have your monkfish, again, you put the monkfish...
Same way, isn't it?
Really? Same way. Or you put it in the foil and put the sauce on top and little pocket in a hot oven. And Bob's your uncle.
Charlie's your aunt.
Thank you, guys.
Thank you, guys.
And you have
and
a good
we'll
night.
See you soon.
Yep.
Bye.
Bye.
Oh, come round, say goodbye. There we go, one last close up. There it is. And say hello to Bernie.
Hello guys. Hello Barbara.
Truly bless. Good night, Ryan. See
you. Yeah man, Fabian. Bless up.
Okay, bye.
Bye.